An address may seem simple, but the USPS has several rules that make things a bit complicated. For example, knowing how and when to list the floor, apartment number, suite, or unit. What about the proper abbreviation for street or avenue? In this quick tutorial, we'll show you how to find the accepted standard for your address. For our example, we'll use the address 2335 South State Street, suite number 100 in Provo, Utah. We'll do this first with the USPS zip code finder. I'll go to tools.usps.com and then click to find it by address. Here, I can type in my address after breaking it into its components. First, I'll put the street address, 2335 South State Street. Then, under the apartment slash suite slash other, I'll put 100. Provo is the city and Utah is the state. Once I click Find, it delivers the address now standardized as 2335 South State Street, Suite 100, Provo, Utah 84606, along with the plus 4, which is 6580. If you have several addresses, you'll need to either click the Look Up Another Zip Code button or set up the USPS Address API. However, there is a much easier way to standardize your address. Go to smarty.com or click the link in the description. At the top, hover over Resources, and then under Demos, select Single Address Verification. Looky here, the very easy to use Single Address Validation tool. You can check any address anywhere in the world. If you want to check one outside of the United States, be sure to select International. I'll do a US address for my example. Under Lookup Type, specify if you're going to use components, address, city, state, and zip code, or freeform. For this example, I'm going full-on freeform. Start entering the address and check it out. The address tool will begin to autocomplete the address for you. You don't even have to type the whole thing if you don't wanna. When you see what you're looking for, just select it. To illustrate a point, I'm going to type out the address rather than selecting from the autocomplete dropdown. Once you select View Results, you'll see on the right side that it has validated and standardized the address. The same as the USPS site, except I didn't have to type in the components individually. Also, right below the results is a map with a pin on the rooftop of the building so that I can be sure that I'm sending to the right place. Want even more information? Scroll down a little further and you'll find a grip of metadata attached to this address. Another thing that makes this better than the USPS is that I can validate up to 10 addresses at a time for free by going back up to Resources and selecting Bulk Address Validation. Here, I can enter up to 10 addresses and have them all standardized at once. Pretty slick, eh? Slick?